So you come back with burgers, another hour goes by, and finally, you see in the darkened room through the camera, because mm-hmm. all you can really see is kind of black and shades of blue, mm-hmm. a white door frame appears on one of the walls.
Shit.
As this happens, I guess someone else is watching the thing. I'm sitting there coloring and being like, you must be swift as a coursing river.
Plus 10 points for Gryffindor.
Seriously. Wait, I thought you were Slytherin.
I think I probably would
You're probably yes. Gryffindor, actually.
Slytherpuff.
That's what I am.
Ravelwind.
It's almost like dividing everyone into one of four things is a terrible system.
Yeah, how about that?
I'm more than one thing. Divergent series. I just recently watched all the Divergent
so
series
bad.
In like quick succession. It was Divergent.
Convergent.
No, it was...
Insurgent.
Convergent was a theoretical name they could have given the fourth one.
Okay.
But they didn't because...
It didn't happen.
It didn't get made.
Okay.
It was Divergent. The third one was... Insurgent, and the second one was...
Resurgent?
No, it was...
I don't care enough to even look it up.
Let's not do this.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is a bad
tangent.
Damn it.
You see a woman, early 40s. She's kind of dressed like... sort of a 1950s pinup, but she has like a really simple skull mask on.
Oh, I love it. I love it so much.
She's got her hair up. She is...
Love it.
A little bit Jessica Rabbit, almost.
Fashionably, I want to be her.
Yeah, me too.
Everybody does. She's just so fashionable.
Actually, maybe the second one was an insurgent. Fuck. It's really bothering me now.
Oh my God. Who cares?
Not worth it, Jordan.
Who cares?
This guy.
Why do you care? They're bad movies.
I just watched them like a week ago.
Just love that that's where he's at right now.
So she walks up to the little case, and you guys can see her through the video feed you have set up. She looks like she's about to open up, pull her hand back, and goes to the other side, makes a little door, and pulls it out. And the trap does not go off. What do you do?
Go, 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 go!
Yeah, definitely, like, from where I'm at...
You're just, like, in the back room of a building, and she's in the show floor. It's not hard to get to her.
Can I use unstoppable and burst through the wall to get to her?
I will allow that.
Yeah, because that's...
Mind you, this is a real place. This is someone's business.
No. I know, I didn't think it out. I was just like, it didn't work.
Well, I'm going through. Let me go first.
Nope, sorry, he already asked.
I was trying to go first, and then.
This is funnier.
Yeah.
Why?
I was like, it didn't go off. Oh shit! And I just like dive through
the
wall.
Yeah, suddenly it's a Police Academy movie.
A little bit.
All right, so that's Unleash My Powers. Oh wait, no, it's not. It's it's an unstoppable roll. So when I smash my way through scenery to get to a wave of something, roll plus danger. And that's a 5, 6, 7. So on a 7 and 9, choose one. Mark a condition, leave something behind, or take something with me. And so I still smash through, but I am going to mark guilty because as soon as I smash through the wall, I realize that these people were doing us a favor and I smashed their wall.
It's Yogurt Land all over again.
Yeah.
So,
so you leave us... Not a swole hole, but a human hole behind you. And she stops and, oh, God damn it.
Okay, so before she does fucking anything, because I wanted to do this before you did your bullshit, is I run out the actual door, because I wanted to, because I realized, like, I definitely have sight limitations on what I can do.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why, like, the disc was, like, unleashing powers. But I basically just, I know that she can, like, exit anyway, but, like, you know, reinforcing some of the seals around, like, the door and stuff like that, and keeping her from running, because I feel like she would need more time to do her own doors and whatnot.
All right, go ahead and roll me freak.
Okay.
Because you are changing
would
the
be
environment.
Freak?
Yeah, you're changing the environment.
Freak. Yeah. Okay.
That would be a 10.
What the hell am I doing here?
No. Different freak.
Maybe a 10.
Well, that's what Jordan was doing.
So,
all right, it works.
Yes.
Yeah.
So as soon as she sees you and then you, she, mm-hmm. fuck this, she kind of wicks her hand and a key appears and she runs to the door.
Sorry. So seeing this, Kid Stardust has kind of this weird, like, inclination that she's going to try something new with her powers that you haven't seen before.
Ooh.
But it involves charging him first.
Okay. I'll let you charge.
Nope. So she's like, no. So
you okay. remember?
Don't you have a reroll?
You do have a reroll.
Yay! All
right.
Thanks, chat.
Nope.
God bless it.
Okay, I'll spend a reroll for
Yay.
You.
Yay! All
right. Because I want to see this.
So that's eight plus. Well, that's just.
It's a flat roll.
Yeah, but I have to mark in condition, so I'm gonna mark insecure. Since she's trying something new for the first time.
Makes sense.
And I have three burn until the end of the scene. So what she's going to do is, you don't see this because you're in front of her at this point, but basically she becomes kind of this just kind of like pool of black and pink energy that kind of transfers from one point to another. And then she resolidifies in front of Skeleton King. She's like, wait, we just want to talk.
Ooh.
Well, darling, I don't. She goes around you, goes for the keyhole, and her key hits solid metal because someone sealed the door shut.
That's right.
God damn it.
Can I?
Steve, I can't believe you did this to me.
I want to yell, Alice, fetch that key!
Work! Poof. Do you need a roll for that?
I think so. It's like a lucky whatever roll mm-hmm. thing.
Did you not write that down?
I did, but I don't.
I could also just melt the key. That's a lot easier.
Come on, lucky. I think it just like gives me a plus one. It has like certain things it can do.
All right.
And then maybe it's just like a.
Well, I won't make you roll for it because she's a little distracted with you popping up and you locking, you basically getting rid of her chance to escape. She's holding it and barf.
Yay! Mm-hmm. Can I? Where are those sheets?
In the pink folder.
I want to write it down better.
You look so happy right now.
Mm-hmm. Puppy on the head.
Yay!
Good so choice, so while he's doing that, I turn to, I kind of get closer and then, Skeleton, we just want to talk. We talked to Steel Blue. He's in. My element family, you know, it's...
Oh, no.
It's fine. It's fine. We just have some questions about the Green Inferno.
She takes her mask off. Beautiful makeup. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Michael Holmes is in love with her.
Yeah, I
imagine.
I think Swole's got, like, he's a little, like, struck by...
Jack probably used to.
The lesbian
dress
and
up
the
like
straight
her.
Guy are both like, oh my.
Well, no, Stardust and the player Michael Holmes are both in love with Skeleton yeah. Key.
Yes.
Whereas both Charlie and Jack are very appreciative of how she is dressed and mm-hmm. how she looks, mm-hmm. but there's nothing happening. Mm-hmm.
Swole like.
Call me Lorraine.
Up his chest a
you realize
bit.
She doesn't have like one of those latex masks or like a leather one. This is like has a silk ribbon and everything. Mm-hmm. It is
she's
all style.
So fancy.
Call me Lorraine.
Okay, Lorraine. Well,
I should have known. Lorraine, you idiot. You should know this.
No,
thing.
Hey, Lorraine, stop. Look, I'm Marie. This is Charlie. This is Theo. This is Kevin. Kevin's around here somewhere.
Kevin's still fucking coloring in
He's
the
He's really
books.
Into his coloring book, man.
Yeah.
Look, it's very complicated, but because of Jonas, we know that you were involved in the group that retrieved the Emerald Inferno, and we're just
did
trying...
Did he call us the Expendables again? Because I told him if he did, I was going to
he
hurt
totally
him.
He totally did. He said he didn't like it. I didn't make a point of it at the time, but I understand where you're coming from.
I don't understand what's wrong with the name.
It's kind of cheesy, because I think, I'll be back. I mean, I know he was only the third one, but...
Children?
Another conversation for another time. Look.
It's better than Suicide Squad.
Gregor Devereaux.
I was part of them.
kind of has it out for you all right now because of your connection to the Emerald Inferno. And if we can retrieve this, this is going to solve a lot of problems for a lot of people.
Now, oh, I know, darling, you know it was going to solve a lot of my problems having a... God, how many carats did you say this diamond was? Because you were in charge. You weren't in charge of spreading the information, but you were the one that was announcing it outside, so...
Over 9,000 carats.
Well,
999.
About that diamond.
Kevin.
It's fake.
Huh, what?
Oh no, darlings. I'm aware. Steve built the trap. The diamond's fake. You were all in the back room. Oh no, this is not my first time at the rodeo, children.
But you're still here.
Sometimes I don't make good decisions. I have impulse control.
Oh, me too. I mean, actually, it's better right now, but a lot of the time.
Oh, is that why you left a U-shaped hole in the wall, darling?
Yeah. His impulse control isn't great anytime.
All right. So you're Steve's boy, or his?
No, I'm in.
All right, Steve's gold... boy is a meat locker.
Meat hand.
Meat hand.
Yeah. No, yeah.
You never did get along.
I'm Golden Orm's legacy.
Oh.
Yeah.
How is he, by the way?
He's fine. I mean, he's in stable condition. Ember's taking care of him in the hospital.
Oh, that's good. Me and Ember always get along.
Mm-hmm. She's great.
Kevin walks out. Hey, what's going on?
Hi.
Yeah. Hey, I'm Kevin. Did you like my illusion? Wasn't it cool?
Yes, darling. It was super cool.
All right. So Kevin gets team move.
Wolfman, make note of that.
We gave Nicole a team move.
Hilarious. You're welcome, marks, Nicole.
I think she marks a potential.
Not happening.
Oh, come on.
You have to be here for it to work.
Oh, come on.
Look, Lorraine, we don't want to cause any trouble for you. We really don't. But I feel like...
Did you really write that?
I did.
I'm going to bop our producer later. Sorry.
Promises, promises.
I mean, yeah, you know, whatever two consenting adults do, it's not my concern.
She's not my type, but I'd fuck her.
Yeah, hey-o. Look, Lorraine, we're really not trying to cause any trouble for you, but it's important for us to talk to the rest of you, your group.
Thank you for not calling it that.
Took me a second, but you're welcome. To figure out what the Emerald Inferno is all about, how we find it, and how we put it to rest. How can you help us with that? We'll do whatever we can to make it worth your while.
We all had a job. We all had a job. Mine was getting in there. It was a ship that had been there for hundreds of years. No one was able to get in until yours truly. Jonas was supposed to be lookout and basically booby. He was supposed to, he was bait. Don't tell him that, but he was bait.
Tell him that, Charlie.
So
tell him
broke in to the place that had the Green Inferno, what did it look like before it was infesting people and...
It was beautiful. She gives you the 1,000-yard stare and everything. It was one of the most beautiful things I ever saw in my life.
Did it infect you at any point? Did it control you?
Not until, everyone got infected. Well, I don't know why. It was just villains. I blame Red Dragon for that one.
So I've got a question. Since that happened, have you been seeing anything strange at all?
Darling, what are you talking about?
Because yesterday when we were preparing for this whole thing, I started noticing what seemed like just like a small green person, child, something. And always in like the corner of my eye, out behind me and stuff.
Darling, I have no idea what you're talking about.
You haven't been seeing anything like that?
No.
Well, fuck me then.
Theo, it's okay.
I
don't know why I keep calling you Theo.
I'll take it.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I mean, she looks you up and down. I do love a man in a suit, but I might be a bit old for you, darling. Oh, don't judge.
No, there's no judgment here. Tell us about the others' jobs. What about, Charlie, you have the list.
Yeah, Anvil.
I'm now like kind of like not sure what to say. Like, her saying that just makes you go,
Garsh.
Do go on.
Also, you mentioned trying on the suit yesterday, so how long have you not been in swole mode?
I figured maybe it wasn't yesterday. I would say it was, like, because we set it up the day of.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah. So.
All right. But you are noticing this is the longest you've gone.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Yeah. So I was like, I'm going to use that for something.
Anvil, Red Dragon.
Really, the only one who needed to be there was Red Dragon.
What can they do?
What does Red Dragon even do? Yeah.
He absorbs. He eats things. If you, darling, if you're curious about, you know, seeing things, ask him.
Well, how he was the vessel with him.
I had never met him before in my life, and I've been doing this for a long time.
Do you know where we can find him?
Our producer's gone ahead and wrote out a timeline for us.
Well,
it's either been 8 hours or a day and a half. We're gonna go with the day and a half.
I'm gonna go with the day and a half.
Yeah.
All right.
That's my headcanon.
Yeah. It's, mm-hmm. Well, that's just canon now.
You get to like sleep in your own bed like a normal person.
Your pet.
Well, because I transformed when we went and found what's his name.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was in his place, and then we did the heist after that.
And you guys set up the heist, so.
I'll go with day and a half.
Your
I like
parents
it. I'm rolling with
had
this.
A moment.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We'll leave it at that.
They could actually hug you without wanting to vomit afterwards. Well,
that's so mean.
Wow. Wow.
That is just mean. That was uncalled for, good sir.
He was less than normal.
Red Dragon was the vessel.
Okay. And how would we get in contact with him?
Oh, darling, I have no idea.
You guys have got to have some sort of way that you
do you think it was a club?
I mean, you guys gave yourself a team name.
No, well, no.
Jonas.
Jonas team name.
That no. Lovable fool gave us a team name. I viewed it as a way to get some red off my paper. And there's a lot of red hiding.
Wait. It was Devereaux who hired you, though, right?
Yes.
Ted, can I talk to you for a sec?
Yeah, sure.
You guys have been doing this a lot lately.
Look, I'm only taking you aside because I know Charlie is still not okay with this. I gotta be honest with you, I'm not 100% okay with it either.
No, look, I get what you're getting
at.
I'm not on board. But
I need to ask you a favor, though. And I fully understand that he's probably hearing me ask you this, so fuck it. Devereaux, where do we find the Red Dragon?
Ding. Come to my office. Ding. Burrito, hot dog, turkey burger. He just said that's really annoying.
Mm-hmm. All right. Excuse me. What was her name again? Skeleton Key.
Lorraine.
Oh, sorry, Lorraine. Could you get us to the Theta Court building?
Oh, certainly. Just give me a moment.
Lorraine.
Yes?
Can you get us out of the Theta Court building?
Oh, honey, I can get out of anywhere. she flicks her hand, and the key disappears from Atlas's mouth with a borf. And it reappears in her hand.
You see him just kind of going around being like...
He starts doing that.
He starts spinning in a circle. Like doing a little like, where he goes like three times in one direction and like turns and goes in another direction.
This is like the best thing we've added to the show.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck the map, fuck the donations, we need more pugs.
Go to hell, W.C. Fields, we're working with kids and children. Wait, what? Okay.
So she takes her key and she traces a rectangle onto pretty much a blank wall. Also, darling, I am not paying for any of this. Draws a handle, reaches in, pulls it open, and you are inside the clock tower at Theta Corps.
All right, Gregor, we're here.
Thanks, doll.
Wait, are you leaving?
She looks very guilty and she closes the door behind. she stays on the other side of the door and closes it.
Son of a bitch. Well, we can always go through walls my way if we need to get out.
You're my way now, too, apparently.
Yeah. Hey, that was cool. We should talk about that.
I know. It just kind of happened.
That's neat stuff.
I saw it, and then I did it.
I still have to go through doors like a normal person.
Yeah.
Because some of us respect structural integrity.
Hey, you know, for some see a door, I see an opportunity. That one didn't work.
No.
Ted, we'll talk later, but now?
Yeah, well, when some Theodore...
Theodore.
I am Theodore.
Sorry.
Theodore.
Theodore?
Yeah.
But first, Devereaux.
No, please. I love the puns. They're adorable. Bill Granger, social media, by the way.
All right. You said you could give us some information about
where
the dragon is.
Buddy, you're my employee, and I always help my employees.
Is this a phone call right now?
No, we're there.
No.
Oh, shit.
Lorraine opened up a door.
Skeleton keyed us to...
I missed that.
Fata Corp, and then left us there.
Sorry, I was checking Facebook, so... My bad. I couldn't access my phone again.
Well, what do you need?
My notification.
And I am so glad to have all of you under my roof right now. I mean, I love it when multi-generation...
All right, cut the chit-chat, okay?
But I'm so
good
at it.
Seriously, you flatter yourself.
You're a dick, says Kevin. Mm-hmm. Felt appropriate, right?
And your dad's in jail.
Appropriate.
What?
And you're stupid.
All right, thanks, Kevin. We got this.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, buddy. Kevin.
No, I'm not mean to Kevin at all. I feel like
that's completely what would be happening right now.
It's pretty in character. You're not wrong.
Yeah, no.
Kevin's nailing it, but we got business.
Kevin's on his A game, but.
Right. I'm like, oh, sick burn. Look, everything we're going to points to the fact that the Red Dragon might be able to tell us more about where this thing is or, like, how it works, where it can go.
The vessel. Yes.
And you're the only one we know who has any way to go.
We had our doorman, our key holder, our burrower, our technician, and our...
Vessel,
thank you. It's been a long day. I had, like, 12 meetings. It has been murder.
Did you actually murder anybody? Are you confessing to murdering someone?
No, what he does technically is manslaughter.
Hey, you can't spell without laughter.
you can hear Kinsurna's eyes roll in her head.
Actually, I think if he planned it and meant to kill them, it's murder, right?
No, but he doesn't do it.
Yeah,
not directly.
All I did was deny some orphans some insurance, okay? Let's move on with our day.
Devereaux, for starters, because my mom was a good Italian woman and she respects the bonds of, you know... Because my mom was a good Midwest gal and she respects hospitality, I want to apologize for the way I behaved last time I was here, and I hope you can sincerely find it in your heart to forgive me.
Water under the bridge. It's fixed. And I got what I wanted out of it,
The thing about this whole Emerald Inferno thing, though, is... feel like a big-time player like you should be able to handle this. It's almost like, well, gosh, almost like you're scared.
You're trying to provoke him, aren't you?
Not directly. No, she's just sassing him, but maybe.
That is provoking.
Oh, fuck it. I'm going to roll to provoke.
But what are you trying to get him to do?
Well, let's see. The options for provoking someone are they stumble, you take +1 forward against them. They err, you gain a critical opportunity. They overreact, and you gain influence over them. Mm-hmm. Or, no, that's for PCs. So...
But you still have to say what you're trying to get them to do.
No, I'm not going to provoke him. I am literally just sassing him, because I'm not quite sure what my end game for that would be.
Fair enough.
It's just flavor text, is what it is.
Yeah.
He still has the same nonplussed, like, oh, you got me, face that he always has. You kind of want to punch it. Look, I'm scared just like the good citizens of Hyperion City. There's a menace on the loose. I want to take care of it. I'm on your side. I don't know why you came into my house and attacked me.
Look, that was back then, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And it might be in the future, too. Who knows how things are going to go? But
I do.
For right now, we need to find this guy, okay?
Oh, no, I hear you.
So
I
just
hear
point you.
You
in the
need
direction
my
so
vessel.
We can
you
stop.
Need the vessel.
Just tell us where to go, tell us who to talk to, and we will do it. And then we don't have to talk
you're
anymore.
You're cute when you're mad. And you feel your arm sort of like.
Theodore?
He gets his cell phone out. Oh, right. I forgot to shut that off already. I'm gonna have to kill my tree, damn it.
Son of a bitch, don't make fun of me.
It's not making fun of you, just something that got brought up. It was an opportunity.
That's rude.
And you start swollen out.
I grab the face stuff as fast as I can and like try and like get them back into place.
You managed to get mostly in.
Yeah. You son of a bitch!
Oh, I'm sorry. It seemed like you guys forgot who was in control here.
God damn it, Gregor. Look.
Hey, I'm trying to help you. I just, you know, I can only take so much sass in a day. I'm a busy man.
You've led our friend on with the hope that you are going to cure him if he brings you what you want. How can we possibly trust you with your behavior the way it is right now?
I mean, I gave him a cure earlier. I can...
Look,
you saw me do it with my cell phone, kid.
And you can turn it off whenever the fuck you want. I ask again, how can we trust
you? It's insurance.
For what?
I have to make sure he does his job.
Look!
I don't have it over you two yet, but I'll figure it out. Actually, I just remembered. How's your mom?
Don't say anything, Charlie.
All right, it's not about...
Break his phone.
Don't bring their families into this too, okay?
I just love how your friend just launches. I'm gonna break his phone.
Look,
don't bring their families into this too.
Got a drawer full of them.
Okay, we have already agreed
that.
To work with
done
you.
I know.
Cut
I
it
know.
Out with the intimidation tactics.
I'm not doing anything.
You know you're lying. We know you're lying. So why say it?
Oh my goodness, you people are so emotional. He throws a folder down on his desk. Swear to God, no wonder people lost the election.
Well, I can't pick up and read that.
What the fuck is this shit?
He's a villain. I'm playing a villain. Do not judge me. I don't like this guy. He's bad.
All right, so Kid Stratus picks up the folder.
That has everything on, well, God, what was he calling them? The Expendables. Ugh, terrible name. But right. Never mark it.
I kind of liked it.
Shocking.
I'm not going to thank you for this, but know that giving us this will help you get what you want.
I know.
All right, well, I guess we should be leaving. On my way out, I, like, every time we get to, like, a door frame, I, like, make it the right size, but just being like, oh, yep, just gotta work my way out through here.
Cartoon style.
Sorry, I'm
yeah, we
mean.
Wanna, yeah,
Amanda,
we wanna talk about
we're gonna
petty.
Have to call the contractor again. I know.
I could have just walked out, but someone had to be a huge app-toting douchebag.
Oh, Devereaux, by the way, I read this article about this kid Richards in New York. Something about unstable molecules. Might want to check it out or not. Fuck you.
And I just
say
go
hi
ahead.
To Kate for me.
And I, well, we know what drawer he keeps all the cell phones in because we've seen him use it. And so I just melt that whole drawer. Just all of the phones. Just all everything in that drawer. Actually, I just melt the whole desk. Because who cares? Who gives a shit at this point?
So you have to go down the emergency exit, but eventually you guys. Get out. You're outside the building. Lorraine's waiting for you. I'm sorry about that.
He's pretty terrible.
Please don't take this the wrong way, but...
It's...
I can't say I'm surprised.
Look. With the push of a button, I go from petty criminal, sometimes member of the Sirens, to... person responsible for one of the biggest terrorist attacks in Hyperion City. You understand, darling?
I do. She's looking through the file. She finds Red Dragon, finds his last known location.
Last known location, Questware District. No given address.
Looks like we've got to go undercover.
No, Swole. Let's go in all guns blazing. We have no time to waste. Well, let's think about this. Where in the quest... Let's think about this. Where in the quest district would you be if you were Red Dragon?
Lorraine, look. Are you well, darling?
I would say...
I got a concussion the other day. I'm still recovering from it. I'm sorry.
Let's go check out Da'Bomb.
I say it's probably Da'Bomb because he's in there trying to soak up all the sick beats.
Ooh.
Boom.
Well, it is available.
I feed my belly with beats.
Yeah. But he got mistaken and he thought they meant B-E-E-T-S.
Sure, because they're good for you.
Yeah.
You know, put a little gorgonzola.
Is he an idiot? Like, what?
Yeah, hey, everybody thought Sears was S-E-A-R-S, but this is actually Sears, so it's different. They also serve, like, beet-flavored drinks at Da'Bomb.
Gross. Do you know anybody, forgive me for asking this, do you know anybody in the Questor district?
Oh,
not
honey.
Evil district.
Oh, let's call a spade a spade. Give me one moment, I'll get a door going, and hold on real quick. She does, like, a little, like... little measuring with her hands real quick. It's like, how big do I have to make this thing?
Or if she pulled out just like a, you know, the measuring, the clothing measuring
right,
tapes.
Little...
Oh, that's exactly what she
that
did.
That'd be so cute. But it's an actual measuring tape. Oh, she's adorable. I love her. She can stay.
I could also like squish down a little bit.
Please
so.
Don't do that. I just ate.
Get used to it after
see,
a while.
I'm just saying it's an those. Option.
I don't want to get used to it.
Yeah, me neither. You and me both, girl.
She starts making the door frame. Charlie, was it?
Yeah.
How is Steve?
He's fine. He's good. He's doing good.
Good.
I think he misses you. But he's good.
And that's a conversation for later, Charlie. Mm-hmm. And with that, she has made less of a door and more of a garage door, but like...
Yeah, that sounds about right.
I live in a garage.
Yeah, we know.
She's already wearing like 4-inch heels. She had to like do the tippy toe thing. It looks, it got silly. It's not even like a good rectangle. It's like you get up there and... And she pushes it open and swings open like a door. Janine, before you start yelling, I apologize. I know I said I'd keep them human shaped, but we have visitors.
Also, before I go through that door, I quickly turn and just punch another hole on the wall. And then I go through the door.
Passive aggression. That's good for you.
I think that might just be aggressive aggression.
Yeah.
Although, I guess it's sort of, yeah.
All right. So you enter and you find yourself in one of the cutest cafes you've ever seen in your life.
In Questware?
In Questware.
Ooh!
Who knew?
Who fucking knew?
Oh, darling, it's a front. Janine, I brought visitors. From behind the counter comes a woman. She's kind of dressed like she's going to a rave, but not. Mm-hmm. Like casual rave wear, we'll just say it's that.
Are we at Da'Bomb?
You are not at Da'Bomb.
Damn.
Da'Bomb is a nightclub. Though you do
it's
hear...
during the daytime.
Well, it's nighttime. Oh. But you do hear... So, please someone gift this.
Terrifying.
Yay!
I want this on my headstone.
Just a little LED screen of Michael dancing on your headstone.
Yes.
I like that.
It's kosher, I'm sure.
In an infinite loop. Just cover my tattoos.
True.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Though, actually, they've been pretty lenient on that recently.
Really? We'll talk about that after the
We will.
Yeah.
She comes out, and she doesn't look... In fact, she looks young. She's your age. She's 16.
Okay. I was like, me, Jack, or me, Charlie?
Charlie.
Okay.
She's Charlie's age.
Okay.
Hi. Mom, are we opening? No, darling. She closed the door behind her. So, what are you guys doing here exactly?
We're looking for someone known as the Red Dragon.
Red Dragon? Mom, what are they talking about? Don't worry about it, honey. Look, we are about 3 blocks away from Da'Bomb. That's the last place I saw him. That's where we got paid. And that's all I'm going to tell you right now.
Okay. Then we can work with that.
Let's go clubbing!
Oh my god, can I come? No.
No.
Yes! Oh, no.
It's all ages. I mean, no.
The bomb is not all ages.
Oh, okay.
Which means that I probably cannot go in if she can't go in.
Well, might have to break a rule or two.
I don't like breaking rules.
Oh. I can get in.
No one ever cards me anymore.
You don't even look like your picture, though, so.
I don't look like a human, so.
I feel like Swole's driver's license photo is actually, like, really, like, pulled back, just so that they can, you know.
It's less of a portrait and more just like a.
A landscape?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm technically classed as a commercial vehicle.
A sloop?
Yeah, okay. I don't know what's going on. Hi, name's Jean.
Hi, Jean. Hi, I'm Swole.
Hi, Jean.
Is that your real name?
Nope.
Oh, what is it?
That's Ted.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Ted.
Yeah, nice to meet you, too.
Hey, I don't think you're going to fit out the front door, but I can get you out the back.
Oh, okay, that's actually, I think I probably could fit out the front door.
Oh, no.
Watch this.
Swole.
And Swole does it, I guess.
Yeah, sure. Swole, like he does it, it's actually, like, he doesn't, like, turn into, like, a small thing and go through or whatever. It's more like, you know how, like, a cat can get through anything they can get their head through?
That's a rat.
Maybe it is. Maybe it's not. But a lot of animals can get through anything they can get their head through just by, like, manipulating it. I kind of do the same thing where it's just like I put my arm through and then, like...
I just look at you and I'm like, Charlie, we've seen some shit. That's...
I have a therapist for PTSD after all of this.
Can I have that number?
Pretty cool, right? Yeah. That hurts a lot!
Lorraine looks properly disgusted. Gene, on the other hand's like,
thanks! Gene Come, Atlas!
Gene lives a sheltered life.
Mm-hmm. Well, when your mom's sort of an anti-hero, I'm sure that she's trying to look out for you in the best way she can.
All right! Let's go clubbing!
Bye, Ted.
Bye, Gene!
She closes the door and they lock it behind you guys. And there you see the bomb. Now, you guys, tell me what the bomb looks like. Because I keep imagining, like, a 1990s villain bar with a giant cartoon bomb on it.
So I imagine it more like it looks like it's built of shrapnel. Oh. Like, so it's got, like, sharp, like, crenellations and stuff all over the thing. And
I'm going to hybridize those two. It started out like that with a giant neon sign kind of akin to Planet Hollywood. But then sometime in the early 2000s, some, like, modern architect was like, no. We're going to bring this up to date and keep it classic at the same time. So what they did is around that did all this weird shrapnel stuff. And if you go inside, it's all like it's a war zone. And yet strangely comfy at the same time. And it's got perfect acoustics.
So, one.
Sorry. Not sorry.
One, I love that. Two, was this one of the many times they tried to make the quest per district not terrible?
Yes.
Sounds like it's from the
they were like,
time.
No, look.
This was an attempt at gentrification.
It was an attempt at gentrification.
I don't know. I feel like Da Bomb would kind of lean into the villain thing.
Oh, eventually
right?
They did. They had to.
Yeah.
I mean, how do you think Soups stayed open?
I feel like they are totally a villain bar, but at the same time, they also like tourists.
Sure. Yeah, it's a sort of place where the
it's for edgy tourists.
The management has like a strict no killing, no fighting policy.
Well, they're also so close to like two other districts that they have to like appeal to other demographics.
Yeah, I mean, if it was right in the center, that'd be a different story.
Yeah.
Well, Soups, for God's sakes. The superhero themed gay bar.
Did we decide at some point that this Hyperion City version of my character Gideon is somehow involved in
the
bomb?
Yeah, yes, the owner is named. What's his last name?
It was Longfellow in the other game.
Gideon Longfuse, as he's legally changed his name to.
Yeah.
Is the owner and operator and architect for Da Bomb.
Yeah. Love it.
Multifaceted man.
And he's also Yeah, even if he's a villain, he doesn't consider himself a villain. He would consider himself
a freedom fighter.
A freedom fighter. Who just happens to blow up some important government buildings at some point.
Look, the charges were dropped. Lay off.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys stand in front of the bomb. And you realize how unfortunate location it is because you got the bomb. Not you're walking this, I mean, it's a long walk, but you're walking this from your apartment, and there's that super cute cafe you just left.
It's a nice cafe.
If you look back, you still see Janine before she's, like, dragged off. Just a really terrible location for a nightclub, but it looks busy.
Quick question.
Yes.
Are we wrapping up soon?
We are wrapping up at 3:45.
I'm so sorry.
All right, we're going to go ahead and do plugs right now because we're almost done.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. It's fine. Hurry it up.
3:45.
Well, so fun fact for the chat. My car blew up on the 405 last night. Well, a tire blew up. And I have to get back to the dealership to pick up my car. Otherwise, I will not have a car until possibly Tuesday.
Where's the car dealership?
It's the mini dealership in Studio City.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
That's I can take you there.
That's why I asked for a ride.
Yeah, no, I can take you there. Well, no, I can take you there because it's only like 35 minutes from here to La Crescenta.
Oh, right.
So I can like swing through there.
Fair enough. Okay, so my name is Stephen Pope. You can follow me on Twitter at @StephenJPope22. Same for Instagram. See me. Well, Michael's not here, so I can say my usual line. See me spiral into depression or talk about board games. It's great. Also, make sure to check out my blog, skipaturn.com. My next review is going to be Cthulhu Pandemic. So, should be fun.
Nice. Jordan? Hi, I'm Jordan Pridgeon. You can follow me on Twitter at Jordan Pidgeon. You can also check out videos that I am a producer on and other capacities at youtube.com/seniorditchday. Also, check out the Nerdist School YouTube channel. Because I direct and create a lot of the videos on that too. And if you're in the Los Angeles area, tonight at 8 o'clock at the Nerdist School on Sunset, I have a sketch show with my group, The Money Pit, and it's going to be great.
That's fantastic.
Hi, Jack Kelly. You can find me on Twitter at Jackson Alexander, where the only vowel is the first A in Alexander. I haven't said this before, you can also find me on Instagram at Steak Me Home Tonight, with steak spelled like the food. It's a Happy Endings reference. And I, the thing that I'm plugging right now is I'm actually raising money for top surgery. I'm having the surgery on February 6th. You can find it on GoFundMe, which is Jack Gets Something Off Their Chest. And yeah, I'm about halfway there and I have, I want to say like 2 more weeks to raise funds before my surgery. I'm going to keep the GoFundMe page open afterward just to help, you know, in case I don't reach the amount. So, yay.
Fantastic.
Fingers crossed.
Mm-hmm. Right, we're doing plugs real quick.
I got nothing right now.
Nothing?
Nah.
Cool.
Michael R. Holmes, everybody. Follow him on Twitter. He's great.
Thank you.
Also catch him out on the Doctor Who stream on Friday on Geek & Sundry. It's great.
Yes. Eric's TBD RPG noon PST on Geek & Sundry Twitch. All right.
That's fun. All right.
Da bomb.
Da bomb. There's no bouncer outside.
That seems weird, right?
This does seem weird.
Hey, let's not look a gift horse in the mouth.
All right.
Let's just head on in.
I still feel weird about going in, though, because I don't want to get in trouble.
It's all right, Charlie.
We'll vouch for you.
We'll figure it
Charlie,
out.
Charlie, you're fighting villains. Come on.
We'll figure it out. We're not.
I mean, you can stand outside if you want, but I think we probably are going to need you in there.
I know.
Kevin, come on.
Yeah, okay, I'm coming.
God.
Kevin's like, what? I've been in clubs
I've
all
been
the
here.
Time. I've... You think I've never been to a nightclub underage? I've totally... Like
I've totally been to Da Bomb.
I'm the mayor of Da Bomb, okay?
They know me here.
Yeah. Hey, you.
Hey, you.
It's not like we're here to try and get you a beer or something. We're just going to talk to someone, okay?
Okay.
Figure it out, Charlie. It's going to be okay.
I just don't want to get in trouble.
I know. We're going to need you in there if things go weird anyway.
Okay.
All right.
All right. So you enter the bar and... it's cacophonous in there.
Cacophonous.
Good word, right?
That's yeah. great.
It's about three stories inside, dance floor on the, dance floor, ground floor, and then something's going on the third floor, but it's dark up there, you can't tell, and it looks like seating on the second.
Is it a quinceanera?
No.
Okay.
Just kind of looks like a really grody nightclub. Mm. Like, it's not cute. Mm-hmm. But strangely homey, as you described.
And perfect acoustics.
And the acoustics are amazing.
Yeah.
That's why you can't hear anything.
Right.
Well, apart from the music.
Right, this is just getting weirder and weirder.
There
this
are people
is just
here.
Getting weirder and weirder.
What?
This is just getting weirder and wait.
Swole dances a little bit. It's just like,
this is just getting weirder and weirder.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, let's, should we split up and try and find any information about the red dragon?
Well, I mean, it's probably easier than if we just move about in a pack. They say you never split the party, but maybe we should in this case.
Okay.
I'm gonna go up top, see what I can see. Charlie, you just stay down here, and if you need to, you know.
I know.
I'll hit the second floor seating area.
All right, Kevin, go see whatever.
He's gone.
Kevin's just gone off
Kevin's,
dancing.
Kevin's just fucked off somewhere else.
Oh, wow. He really does know people here.
Yeah, that's a surprising thing.
Oh,
what?
What
the hell?
We thought this was bravado.
Yeah.
Apparently not. So, you took the top floor, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you get the top floor. There's an elevator. It's not hard to get on or anything. It's kind of like a drug den up there. There's a lot of people snorting stuff, smoking stuff. Everyone looks a little bit like either out of it or like they're about to do it. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of shaped like a U almost, mm-hmm. and you're right here. Mm-hmm. You notice everyone's like in groups, but the far end, you see something, at the far right end, you see something red. Not like glowing or anything, which is like an unnatural looking red.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's probably a good lead.
Pull up my big girl pants and just start confidently striding over.
Sitting there, you see a man who is grotesquely deformed, similar to Swole, but Swole's probably a little luckier. Mm-hmm. Out of his skull are large protruding horns. Mm-hmm. His skin is like fire engine red. His hands are gnarled, and he's not wearing shoes. And you see kind of like scaled clawed feet.
Mm-hmm. I want to take a wild guess and say this is Red Dragon.
Mm-hmm. Red Dragon? No, actually, that's my brother. I'm Crimson Dragon.
Crimson, yeah. Actually, I've been thinking about Crimson Wyvern. Is that too much?
Yeah. He's
the Scarlet Dragoon.
He's the smoking Scarlet from Dragoon. A hookah.
What was that?
He's smoking from a hookah.
Okay.
Of course he is. Because he's also part Cheshire Cat.
Of course.
Oh, sorry. Wrong Alice in Wonderland drug reference.
Yeah,
my on. Bad.
Hello?
Red Dragon?
Kid Stardust?
Oh shit, he knows who you are.
You've been expecting me.
I haven't, but they have.
There's no one up here that's not like Roland.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, that's right. His eyes flash green for a second. You probably can't see them. And that's where we're gonna wrap it.
Oh, god damn it.
Fuck. Shit.
Dope.
Woo!
That's good stuff, Steven. Thank you.
See, your cool. MFA in screenwriting does come in
yeah,
handy.
Yeah, totally.
You just don't get paid for it.
No, it doesn't.
It will. By and by.
I can't even write copy for like shitty pharmaceuticals.
No.
Anyway, right. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure to come back in about 5 o'clock call time, correct? for?
Yes. 5 o'clock PST for Phoenix Dawn Command.
They're in the Upside Down, and it's awesome.
And Ink is kind of he's going through some stuff right now.
You're kind of going through stuff in a lot of your games, it feels like.
Yeah. I think I also just need to start rolling worse so I can use my reroll token.
Seriously, I need to start being a dick to you guys so I can use mine.
Yes, all of those things, all the rerolls.
Mm-hmm. Make sure, if you're, we've recently relaunched Black Bag. That should be on this Friday, if I'm not mistaken.
Black Bag Vikings.
Black Bag Vikings. Vikings versus Cthulhu. Like, come on. This is awesome.
I like it.
Don't forget to check out Jack's GoFundMe. Is that what it is?
Please, yes.
Please check that out if you can. Please. I'm sure someone will...
Jacket something off their chest.
Jacket something off their chest. Google that. It's really not hard to find. If you went to the protest today, thank you. Mm-hmm. You did a good thing. If you just kind of support at home, hey, you did good too.
Good for you.
So, see you guys in an hour and have a good weekend.
Bye,
bye everybody.